Hey everybody, I'm Tim Downey from Grace Church of Avondale, and today we are going to talk about how to handle criticism. We all have people who think we should do things differently and have no problem telling us. So I want to give you a couple of scriptures to help you keep your bearings in the middle of criticism from people. And the first scripture that I always think about when I'm being criticized by someone is 2 Corinthians 5:17, where it says that if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old is gone and the new has come. And I have to remind myself in that moment of who I am, my identity in Christ. I have to remind myself that I don't have to always identify by what people say about me. That no matter what they say, ultimately, God is going to be my judge. And ultimately, if I am in Christ, then I'm a new creation. I have a new heart, a new identity, all of it. And with that, I have His righteousness. And so God is a God who looks into the heart. And so I know in that moment of criticism, He's looking into my heart. So if they're saying something out of a spirit of destructive criticism, then I know that I am still found confident, secure in who I am in the Lord. And just to distinguish for a minute, there is two types of criticism. You know, there could either be destructive criticism where someone is intentionally saying something to you to tear you down because they either want to feel better about themselves or they want to control your life in some way, you know, whatever. And then there is constructive criticism where someone who genuinely cares about you gives you a word of criticism because they want to see you grow as a person or as a believer. Now, those things are very differently, but sometimes it's hard to decide what's constructive and what's destructive. And so you just have to ask the Holy Spirit, you know, are they saying this to me out of a place of trying to feel better about themselves or because they just think that, you know, controlling my life in some way is going to help them feel better about themselves? I don't know. Or are they saying that because they genuinely want to see you grow as a person and as a Christian? And when it comes to destructive criticism, you know, remind yourself of the love of God. Remind yourself of your identity in Christ. You know, John 15:9, Jesus says, "As the Father has loved me, so also have I loved you." And if you just take that one verse in John 15:9, you can be confident in every situation where someone is criticizing you destructively, and just know that you are found secure and perfect and blameless in the love of God, which is in Christ. Now, on the other hand, when it comes to constructive criticism, there are situations where someone genuinely wants to tell you something that they want to help better your life and better you as a person. And because of pride in your mind and self-protective mechanisms, you refuse to hear it. And the Proverbs has a lot to say about taking wise counsel from people. And one of my favorite Proverbs is Proverbs 10:17. And it says, "People who listen when they are corrected will live, but people who will not admit wrong are in danger." And what that means is that there is a correlation between your life and your well-being, and being able to listen to the wise counsel of others and listen to constructive criticism when they're saying, "Hey, unless you put this boundary up, you're in danger." And there's a correlation between danger and refusing to admit that you're doing anything wrong. And you can know that you have the righteousness of Christ, that you have a good heart in Him, and that as you identify with Him, you're made perfect with Him, but still do things that are not wise and that do not bear fruit. And so pay attention when somebody is giving constructive criticism in your life, because ultimately, if they're doing it out of a spirit of constructive criticism, you want to hear it because it's going to better you. And when you don't know, ask the Holy Spirit. Say, "Holy Spirit, are they doing this because they want to see me grow, or are they doing this because they are trying, in their insecurity, they are trying to feel better about their own life?"